It's so nice to have the kindergarten with us today. I'm glad you guys are here. We're going to stand to pray our vocations prayer in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Jesus, you are the Good Shepherd. You know each of us, and you call us by name to serve the faith. Help us respond generously to your voice. Give courage and guidance to those you call to the priesthood, diaconate, religious life, single life, and sacramental marriage, so they may respond wholeheartedly and serve devotedly. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Sacred silence, holy ocean, gentle water washing over me, help me listen, Holy Spirit, come.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. May the grace and the peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning, Father.
God has given us the gift of a new day. May we live it the best we can. May we come here ready to learn from Jesus. May we recognize that he longs for us all to have life and to share in his ways of love. And so brought together here, may our prayer help that to happen. May we enter into this time and may it prove to reach our hearts and remind us all of all that we know that we share together in faith. And so it's in your as your children, we greet this new day. We begin by first acknowledging the times that we have not done all that we should have, and there's times that we've sinned. And for those times, we rely always on your mercy, but have hope that you bring us back through all that we share here. And so it's in that way that we come humbly to this holy place to take part in sharing all that we do. Lord, may our prayer always help us to know your presence. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, may our desire be to do our part by sharing your love. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, may we always learn from your way and from your example, and may we try to model it. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us and forgive all of us of our sins and bring all of us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us pray. Look upon your family, Lord, that through the chastening effects of bodily discipline, our minds may be radiant in your presence with the strength of your with our yearning for you. Through through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, just as from the heavens the rain and the snow come down and do not return there till they have watered the earth, making it fertile and fruitful, giving seed to the one who sows and bread to the one who eats, so shall my word be that goes forth from my mouth. It shall not return to me void, but shall do my will, achieving the ends for which I sent it. The word of the Lord. From all their distress, God rescues the just. From all their distress, God rescues the just. Glorify the Lord with me. Let us together extol his name. I sought the Lord, and he answered me, and delivered me from all my fears. From all their distress, God rescued the just. Look to him, that you may be radiant with joy and your faces may not blush with shame. When the poor one called out, the Lord heard, and from all his distress he saved him. From all their distress, God rescued the just. The Lord has eyes for the just and ears for their cry. The Lord confronts the evildoers and destroy remembrance of them from the earth. Their distress, God rescues the just. When the just cry out, the Lord hears them, and from all their distress, he rescues them. The Lord is close to the brokenhearted, and those who are crushed in spirit, he saves. All their distress, God rescues the just. From the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory
to you, O Lord. Jesus said to his disciples, in praying, do not babble like the pagans, who think that they will be heard because of their many words. Do not be like them. Your Father knows what you need before you ask him. This is how you are to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this daily our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. If we forgive men their transgressions, your heavenly Father will forgive you. But if you do not forgive them, neither will your Father forgive your transgressions. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
There are many, many people who have often said that some of the most important things you ever learn in your whole life, you learn in kindergarten. And you know what? I agree with them. Because when you come to kindergarten, you have all sorts of time to work hard and to think about where you're at and to enjoy being together. And you get to come to your classes and you get to make friends and you get to see how important it is to get along. And in kindergarten, you learn how you want to be a friend and you learn how to treat people who surround you. And you learn to care about them. And there's just so much that we can be thankful that we learn in kindergarten. And hopefully when we learn those things in kindergarten, it sets us in a way that helps us all to know that it is a gift every day. We have the chance, many chances for us to make use of our minds and to seek to understand things. And with every single day, we're given the chance to do our part to fill our hearts. And there's so much that we, again, learn in kindergarten. And so I can't help but when we come here today and when we pray as we do, Jesus teaches us again how to pray. And I can't tell you how powerful it was for me this morning to just be reading the gospel and to be, I started praying the Our Father and you know what you guys did? You joined in. I started hearing everybody, I heard you all just joining in prayer. That's a great thing. That's another reminder of what we learn when we get to kindergarten. We learn how to pray. And we get to know that we are so blessed to have all that we do and receive all the gifts that we do as God's children. And so, how can it be any other way than for us to come together as God's children on a day like today and to be grateful for that and to recognize how beautiful it is that every time we pray, when we ask God to open our hearts and when we let that Holy Spirit, it helps us to grow closer to God our Father. And it gives us the chance, again, to learn who we are as God's children. And so we have that most beautiful prayer, the Lord's Prayer, where we address our Father. Hallowed be your name. Your kingdom's going to come. And we're all a part of that. And so we want to cooperate with that. We want to do our part. We want to open ourselves up to God's grace. That it takes our nurturing our souls. It takes our being able to hear his word and allow it to reach our hearts and fill us with the light of a new day to recognize that we're so blessed to be where we're at, to never take time for granted, to recognize that we are given our daily bread through what we share here, this communion that draws us together as God's children for the life of the world. And so on this glorious day, I hope that we can take what we share here, how we pray here, and that it will help us for the rest of the day, that we can see God's work in the beauty that surrounds us, in our time with other with our friends, in our time being able to be out in the midst of a beautiful day like today, where the air is so fresh and the sun is shining and it feels good to be alive. And so may we be grateful. May we be grateful for where we're at, what we share, but most especially always the blessings of being able to wake up to a new day, to nurture our souls, and to trust that through doing just that, we are brought closer to him and come to know in a deeper, deeper way his love that he has for all of us as children. One of the other things that we learn in kindergarten is to tie our shoes, don't we? And you almost saw Father Tom trip 3 times because my shoes came untied. So I better tie my shoes back up. And now I have a big knot in it, so I better wait till after Mass is over. Rising up together, sharing all that we do, we come before you now, O Lord. We ask you, please, to hear our needs. We pray on this day that we all, as your children, that we may make the most of what we're blessed to do, that we may every day make use of our minds, our hearts, and our hands, and through doing so that we'll try to make your world a better place. For this we pray to you, Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we can trust that when we pray, that it helps us to draw closer to you and to know your longing for us to have much life and share it together through Jesus. We pray to the Lord. We pray for all of our families. Watch over them. Be with any of them that are in need. Show where you are. Be revealed in ways that show them your presence. For this we pray to you, Lord. We pray for all children that they may always know that they're loved and wanted and cared for, that they may always have many settings around them that are life-giving and people that are around them that inspire them to seek, to grow, to become, discover their goodness and giftedness. For this we pray to you, Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all of our eighth graders as we're in the midst of confirmation going on with 2 of them last night, 2 of them today, that all of the confirmandi may come to know the power of your Holy Spirit working in their lives and that they may have an openness to respond with conviction always and forever to your gospel and within your church. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all those that are in need of help or healing, those that have already begun this day feeling its difficulties, that you will be with them, that you will show your power, your presence, your peace, that you'll see to it that they have instruments around, instruments of your love around them. For this we pray to you, Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In thanksgiving that we can wake up, that we may never take a day for granted, that we may cherish the many, many opportunities that we know that we're all given to live and to love. For this we pray to you, Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we pray for all those who've died, that they may shine forever in your kingdom with all the saints and the angels. For this we pray to you, Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty God, our Father, we thank you for all that we know that we share together in faith and all that we receive as gift from Jesus. May these prayers be received in his name, for we know him forever as the way and the truth. We trust and love him as brother, for we know he shall one day take all of us to you, to where you live forever and ever. My brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice,
from your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all of his holy church. Receive, O Creator, Almighty God, what we bring from your bountiful goodness, and be pleased to transform this temporal substance that you've given us, that it may bring us eternal life through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty Eternal God, for through bodily fasting you restrain our faults, raise up our minds, and bestow both virtue and its rewards through Christ our Lord. Through him, the angels praise your majesty. Dominions adore and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exultation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim, Holy, holy, Lord, God of hosts. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread into his hands and he gave you thanks and praise. He broke the bread, he gave it to his disciples and said, take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving you thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, The blood of the new and the eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this bread of life and this chalice of salvation, giving thanks you've held us even worthy to be here today in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that by partaking of the body and the blood of Christ, we may be brought together and gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, with George, our Bishop, with the bishops, the clergy, the religious, and the entire people that your Son Jesus has gained as your own. Remember also our brothers and sisters who've fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all those who've died in your mercy. And this morning we do remember Sabu Matthew. Welcome him and all into the light of your faith. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin, Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, the glorious martyrs, Saint Patrick, and all the saints who pleased you throughout the ages, that we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. And rising up together as God's children, and as one, and praying with our whole hearts, we pray the words that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. And graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. The power and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give to you." Look not at our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance to your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with all of you. And how about with keeping social distancing, but as reverence of one another, if we could just bow to each other or put our hands over our heart or a peace sign, okay? Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. It's peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are we called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say your word and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ bring us to everlasting life. We have gone back to coming forward for receiving communion. However, we're doing it in sections, and so if we could start with this whole section, and then once you guys are finished, then we'll move over to this section. If you could try to keep social distancing as far as you can from group to group of about 6 feet from whoever you're come up, feel free to come up with who you're seated with, though.
One.
Let us pray. Grant us through these mysteries, Lord, that by moderating earthly desires, we may learn to love the things of heaven. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your lives.
Thanks be to God.
But before we have our closing hymn, I think that you kindergartners deserve a pat on the back. So give you guys a pat on the back. Good job. Great job today, all of you.
Keep us apart.